broken down. I heard my mammy say to my pappy, let's call it John Henry Brown. So walk on, boys. Walk on down the road. There ain't nobody in this whole wide world that's gonna help you carry your load. But I left my mammy and pappy long about the age of 10. Lord, I got me a job working on the levee, toting water to the hard-working men. Walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. There ain't nobody in this whole wide world that's gonna help you carry your load. One day my pappy, he told me some advice I'd like to give to you. Son, you find a good woman, be good to her, and she's gonna be good to you. So walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. There ain't nobody in this whole wide world gonna help you carry your load. Should ask you, who is that fella Brown? You can tell him I'm the man who left his hammer smoking when he beat that steam drill down. So walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. There ain't nobody in this whole wide world that's gonna help you carry your load. Walk on down the road. There ain't nobody in this whole wide world gonna help you carry your load. So walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. There ain't nobody in this whole wide world gonna help you carry your load.
I have some help from some friends here. I have actually put together a great bluegrass band here. Welcome, Biscuit. Jared. He plays a five-string banjo.
Y'all getting tired of me yet?
This lady right here, I only met today, but she's a great fiddle player, and we've been jamming backstage. Annie Stamer. Over here on the bass, everybody knows Miss Jody Harbin from the Kamps. Here's my old buddy. I met Alan Bobby when he was just a kid. Of course, he's not much older than that now. But I met him when he was about 14, 15 maybe, and he was a great mandolin player back then. I knew his dad. His dad was a great banjo player. And we've crossed paths over the years several times at the local fiddlers conventions around North Carolina and Virginia, and he's quite the mandolin player. We're going to play a couple of good old bluegrass tunes for you here. The first one being a tune that Bill Keith made famous with Bill Monroe. It's called Salt Creek. How many of y'all ever heard Salt Creek? Oh, look at that. You know, I hate it when the audience knows how the chin's supposed to sound. If you'd have never heard it, then we could just play anything and you wouldn't know whether we was doing it right or not. A little old white-haired lady told me one time at a house concert, she said, "I wish you'd play something I know, son, so I could tell whether you're any good or not." Another little old lady, as they was leaving, you know, they'd all shaking hands, this little old lady came up to me and she said, "You know, son, I don't like music much, but I like what you do." I had to think about that all the way home, you know. Here's the Salt Creek. Thank you. great fiddle player, man. She's as happy as she can be doing it too, because both feet, she's patting both feet up here. One to the other. I can't hardly do that. Now that we're all totally out of tune. I'm good, yeah. Leave it up to the banjo player, right? Must be a banjo joke in there somewhere. We're going to do another old bluegrass standard for you called Dark Hollow. I hope y'all never heard this either. Front center. Man, it's a lot of fun to play with people like that. This next song that I'm going to do, I do this almost every time I come here. Did it last week. It's in remembrance of the man who wrote this song. It was a good friend of mine named Ray Klein. He was on the police force of Statesville, North Carolina. He was a sergeant. He was a great guitar player and a good songwriter. And he wrote this song in the early 70s, and I heard it. And I thought, if I ever made a CD, if I ever tried to sing on a CD. See, I'm better known as a guitar player than I am a singer. I kind of sing like a man in jail, and, which is behind a few bars and can't find the keys. So, Ray used to do these little licks. I used to go watch the band he played in warm up at the Fiddler's Convention, at the old schoolhouse Fiddler's Conventions, and he'd do licks right in the middle of whatever they were singing, just so I could watch him. And then I'd turn my guitar and try to do it, and if I couldn't get it right, I'd look back over at him and he'd do the same thing again. Even though they changed keys, whatever, you know, it didn't matter to him. What, Ray, what are you doing, you know? Well, he was showing me how to do stuff. But he wrote this song in the mid-70s, and I recorded it, I think, around 2008. And the day the CDs arrived at my house was the day Ray died. So he never got to hear this song. And I've done it many times for him since, and I hope he's listening tonight. And if you like it, it's on a red CD over here with my name on the front. And I appreciate you taking time to look at them as you go out and maybe take one home with you. Of course, I'd like you to pay for it first. I want to thank Steve and Donna again for having me here again this year. I had a wonderful time. Had a wonderful class. They know a lot of banjo jokes. So over here at the display of mercantilism, when all this is said and done, I'll be over there, and if you need help looking for this song, I'll help you. And I'll also have my Sharpie if you would like it autographed. I can autograph it, which will activate it. This is called You Can't Take It With You. Thank you all very much for sitting and listening to us. We've had a wonderful time. All the places that I've been, and all the things that I've done, and all the hearts that I've won are a fading memory, like the clouds rolling by. Could have made good had I tried. Would it help me when I die? Just a freeborn country boy. I hate the thought of growing old. Cause each morning is a window that opens up to free my soul. When I'm old, should I be proud? I couldn't take it when I died. Couldn't take it when I die.